The best way to find out which is the best 360 virtual tour camera is in an 8K super high resolution 360 video. And you are watching it right now. Today, we will compare Sony Alpha 1 with a Sigma 8mm, Xphase Pro X2, Ricoh Theta Z1, Insta360 ONE X2, Qoocam 8K, and even the $30,000 VR camera, Kandao Obsidian Pro, in virtual tour photography. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. This is an 8K 360 video, so make sure you set the video quality in 8K and look around. I'm going to tell you my opinion, but I'm also going to challenge you to draw your own conclusion based on the result you see in this video. There is lots of misinformation on the internet, and I hope this example video helps you to find your next professional HDR virtual tour 360 camera. We are only going to focus on the absolute best image quality each camera is capable of with the best professional photo editing workflow, which you already learned on this channel. We are not going to discuss pricing, workflow, usability, and all that. I will save those in a dedicated 2D review video coming up. At the end of the day, virtual tour professional and 360 photographers want to capture and present the best possible images. The reason why I have almost 1 million views on Google Street View in less than 4 months, thousands of likes and shares on my 360 photo on Facebook, and close high-end commercial clients, is all because of one simple thing. My 360 photos has the best quality, period. Before I give you the ranking, all the results you are seeing are HDR 360 photos. If you don't do HDR in 2021, well, you should really just learn how to do it, no excuse. Rank number one, which has the absolute best image quality, is a mirrorless or DSLR camera with a fisheye lens. Not just any DSLR, you have to get a full frame camera like the Sony Alpha 1 as you see right here, or the Canon R5. Pair it with a decent fisheye lens. I use the Sigma 8mm here, which is one of the affordable high-end fisheye lens. If you want to find the absolute best fisheye lens with only two shots for a full 360 immersive photo, check out my tutorial right here. The reason why Sony Alpha 1 is my top choice is the color. HDR 360 photo out from the Sony Alpha 1 with my PT Guri workflow has the best natural looking color. You can't really tell this is an HDR photo, and that is the beauty of it. It also gives you a 12K 360 photo, the best resolution on almost all virtual tour software. If you capture nature and outdoor virtual tour like me on Google Street View, the max resolution is 14K on Google. Write this information down. In terms of image quality, Sony Alpha 1 or any DSLR have things I don't like: ghosting in HDR and missing the deer. Ghosting is not such a big issue for indoor virtual tour, but for outdoor virtual tour with people and animals, you will see HDR ghosting. Sony Alpha 1 has the less ghosting among all full-frame cameras out in the market thanks to the super fast capture speed, but still, it has ghosting. Another very annoying thing about a DSLR with a fisheye lens is the nadir. Look down, and you see a black box missing pixel right here. It is extremely annoying to do a ground shot on location. So, if you want to go for the absolute best image quality, just learn how to use a professional photo camera like the Sony Alpha 1 right here. Rank number 2, Xphase Pro X2. After months of shooting virtual tour and outdoor nature in Yosemite National Park with the Xphase new camera, I am convinced this is the best one-shot 360 camera. You are seeing the result of Xphase Pro X2 right now in the exact same condition. Even the Xphase does not have rich color like the Sony Alpha 1, it looks very close to Sony Alpha 1. in image quality. The dynamic range of Xphase is ridiculous good. Look up at the hot California sun. Everything is still beautifully captured. It does not have the problem of the old Xphase S2 in stitching and color. If you look down, you can see me clearly, still very sharp. There is no 360 camera that has the same sharpness, even in Zenith and Nadir. It also does not have ghosting on moving scene. It is all around the best one-shot camera if you care about image quality. What about indoor virtual tour? According to others, Xphase is really bad for indoor virtual tour. Well, not anymore. Xphase Pro X2 has a new enhanced stitch algorithm that's almost flawless indoor or outdoor. Take a look at yourself. If you don't think this is challenge enough, how about this one? In DSLR, this location will be a control point nightmare, but Xphase Pro X2 handle it like a champ. Look down. You can even read the book title. That is some crazy sharpness that no other camera has. Is it easy to get this result with the Xphase Pro X2? No, not at all. There are a learning curve and editing techniques you need to master on this camera, just like Sony Alpha 1. I will go into details on my 2D Xphase Pro X2 review and tutorial video coming up next. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss that tutorial. Rank number 3, Ricoh Theta Z1. Now you are looking at the result of a Ricoh Theta Z1 using the third-party plugin Dualfisheye RAW to capture this HDR 360 photo. This is the best way to get a professional-looking result from the Z1. The 2021 new update makes it super fast to capture HDR, so there will be no ghosting whatsoever, indoor or outdoor. If you want to learn more about the new Theta Z1 51GB version, which is used in this photo, check out my 2021 reviews right here. Rank number 4, Insta360 ONE X2. Now you are looking at the 9 bracketed HDR DNG result from the Insta360 ONE X2. This is a consumer camera, not a professional camera, so don't expect to see the professional result, no matter what kind of photo editing trick you are using in post. To even better illustrate my ranking, let's zoom in 300% to take a look at the side-by-side comparison result right here. By the way, I also provide this photo for download, link in the description down below. Sony A1 has the overall best natural looking image. If you have been to Laguna Beach, California, this is exactly what it looked like in real life. The over 12K resolution keeps the detail, even in the distance. But the Xphase Pro X2 come really close to second place. If you look at the 800% zoom circle, Xphase has the best clarity. You can literally see inside the hotel room, which is like miles away. The sharpness and clarity is even better than the Sony Alpha 1 in this regard. Theta Z1 cannot hold the image quality in distant object even though it has beautiful color. It is not a good camera for outdoor virtual tour where distant details are important for the photo. Insta360 ONE X2 is just bad. I wouldn't recommend any serious 360 photographers to use ONE X2. What about Qoocam AK and Qoocam AK Enterprise? You are looking at it right now. We did a separate test at Yosemite National Park to compare Kandao Obsidian Pro, which is essentially an A-shot DSLR, Xphase Pro X2, and Qoocam AK. To save you some time, let's go directly to the side-by-side comparison. Xphase Pro X2 again has the best resolution and sharpness. The color is also beautiful, except for the purple spot right here, which is a common issue that I will go into details in my Xphase Pro X2 official review. Kandao Obsidian Pro at the time of recording does not have HDR or DNG-A features, so the color is quite flat, and the dynamic range is not as good as the Xphase, but it is a 3D camera and the sharpness is just as good as the DSLR, so I still rank it number 1. HDR feature will be coming out soon in Obsidian Pro. Qoocam 8K, on the other hand, still suffer from blurry focus issue in the far away object. The half dome is really far from glacier point, which is where the photo is taken, but still, compared to Xphase, this sharpness is just bad. So, just like ONE X2, I would recommend it for outdoor virtual tours. So now you have a clear idea of my ranking. Just to recap, a professional mirrorless camera or Kandao Obsidian Pro or Insta360 Titan is number 1 in image quality, followed closely by Xphase Pro X2, Theta Z1 is number 3 with dual fisheye plugin, Qoocam 8K is number 4. I would recommend Insta360 ONE X2 for virtual tour. I have not mentioned LED panel Pilot 1cc. It's because it cannot really do HDR360 photo just yet, and it still has some coloring issues. As you see in this comparison, Xphase Pro X2 is the black horse. It is the most underrated camera that nobody knows. If you know how to edit HDR360 photo, this camera is probably the best for most virtual tour jobs. In the next 2D review video, I will go into detail about Xphase Pro X2 and how to use custom script, SNS HDR Pro, and other Photoshop or Affinity Photo techniques to get the best professional result out of this camera. If you're like me, strive to create the best 360 virtual tour, this is the video you don't want to miss. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new here. Please give me a thumb up and share this comparison video to people you are arguing with online. Let them see the image quality with their own eyes. It's usually the best way to get your point across. I will see you next time or see you in virtual reality. Ciao.